Good morning, everybody. In computer network, today's class is going to be about communication satellites. You all know what is a satellite. Here, this satellite is going to be used only for the communication. That is why it is called as the communication satellites. It is divided into three categories. Those three categories we are going to study. And then how the satellites are going to be used compared to this fiber optic cables. That is only we are going to learn today. Okay. What is communication satellite? It is going to be about all the four topics. Okay. First one is about kinds of satellites. According to the properties, the satellites are divided into three categories. What are the three categories? Geostationary, Earth orbit, medium Earth orbit, low Earth orbit. Okay, according to the distance from the Earth, the satellites are going to be launched. Okay, this is the picture. You can go through it. Okay, just to see this low Van Allen belt, upper Van Allen belt, then this. So, the kilometer distance from the Earth, if it is from 5000 to 15,000 kilometer, it will be low Van Allen belt. If it is going to be from 15,000 to 20,000 kilometer, it is upper Van Allen belt. So, this low Earth orbit, LEO satellites can be placed from the earth up to 5000 kilometers. From 5000 to 15000, the satellites are placed means it will be medium Earth orbit satellites. If it is above the 35000 kilometer, it will be called as the geostationary satellites. Okay, so here you can see the latency. Latency means according to the milliseconds, how long it will take to reach that. And sats needed for the global coverage. How many satellites you have to place. Okay. So, if it is going to be from 0 to 5000 kilometer, you need 50 satellites. If it is going to be from 5000 to 15,000, you need 10 satellites. If it is above 35,000 kilometer, 3 satellites, which means it is going to cover the entire Earth. Understood? So, if it is the low Earth orbit, it will be the necessity with the 50 satellites. If it is medium Earth orbit, it will be with 10 satellites. If it is going to be above this 35,000 kilometer distance, it is with the need of 3 satellites. Okay. So, this satellites is having some attractive property for many applications. So, each and every satellite will have many transponders. What it will do? It will listen some portion of spectrum, amplifies the incoming signal, then rebroadcast it if it is necessary. It will avoid interference with the incoming signal. This mode of operation is also known as bent pipe. The higher the satellite, the longer the period. Near the surface of the Earth, the period is about 90 minutes. So, satellite period is important. So, how it is going to be used? First, we are going to learn about geostationary satellite. So, geostationary satellites orbit will be from 36,000 kilometer above from the fixed location. So, VSAT computers can communicate with the help of the hub. Hubs will be placed in between, and through those hubs, it can have a communication. And up and down time is about 250 milliseconds. Within this 250 milliseconds, you can upload the data and also you can download the data through the satellite. Here the problem is voice. Okay, there is a problem in voice satellite. Okay, so here complete communication system are used with this geostationary satellite. So these satellite will become multi-million dollar business. So that this high flying satellites are called as geo satellites. And modern satellites will have 5000 kilogram and it consuming several kilowatts of electric power produced by the solar panels. Consequently, this ITU, International Telecommunication Union, allocated some frequency bands to the satellite users. That is listed in the figure. Okay, you can see this figure. These are the different types of bands is allocated by the ITU, International Telecommunication Union. C band is used for commercial satellite. L and S bands are added by the international agreement. Next highest band is the K band. Bandwidth also allocated with KA, that is K above, okay, which is for commercial satellite traffic. Understood? So C, LS, KU, KA, these are the different types of bands. And this 5 geostationary satellites will be from 1/3 of Earth's surface, so that it is called as footprint. Okay, and typically it will be used called spot beams and very small aperture terminals. Okay, that will be sometimes added with the communication satellite. Okay, next one is the, so this is the geostationary satellite, how the figure will be, then the points on the geostationary satellites and different types of bands which is supported by this geostationary satellite. Next we will move on to the medium earth orbit satellite. So this will be with the lower attitudes between the two Van Allen belts, so that it is called as medium earth orbit satellites. So they are lower than geo, so that they have a smaller footprint. Okay, less powerful transmitters to reach them. And currently it is used for navigation system rather than telecommunications. So the roughly 30 GBS, Global Positioning System satellites, orbiting about 20,200 kilometers are the examples of MEO satellites. Next one is the low Earth orbit satellites. Moving down to the altitude, we will get this low Earth orbit satellites. In 1990, Motorola broke a new ground by filling an application with the FCC, which is asking for the permission of launching 77 low orbit satellites for Iridium project. So, Iridium project. This plan was later revised with the use of 66 satellites. This Iridium project was implemented with 66 satellites. So, after filling it, after the permission was launched, and then it will be implemented, and it has been for the Iridium project. Next. So, here only we have the system such as Iridium may use low latency satellites and it could coverage the route communications with them. So, each satellite will have four neighbors. Okay. Four neighbors will be there for each satellite. So here we need 66 Iridium satellites for from 6 necklaces around the Earth. Yes, this is about low Earth orbit. And another one is the Global Star, which is the satellites switches in a space. Okay, so turning means rounding the space, rounding the Earth. Okay, relaying in space. This is relaying in a space. And the next one is the relaying on the ground. Okay, sometimes it could be facing on the ground. So, next one is the satellite versus fiber. How the satellites are compared with the fiber optical cables. First, we will see satellite. First, the advantage of satellite is it can rapidly set up anywhere, anytime communications. And it can broadcast to large regions. And it will be, the disadvantages is limited bandwidth and interference to manage. Next, fiber. So, it is enormous bandwidth over long distances. Installation can be more expensive and difficult. It does not work at sea or in remote areas. These are all the comparisons with satellites and the fiber. So, with this, the communication satellites class has been over. We'll see the next topic in the next class.